Hello friends, I welcome you to JEE Main April 2019 Video Solutions. I hope you have performed to the best extent of yourself in the paper. Now it's time to know what are the right answers to these questions and what is the step-by-step solutions as well. Let's start with the very first question. We will be taking the morning session paper of 8th April. The very first question of this paper, this belongs to section mechanics and the topic would be momentum. Two particles move at right angle to each other. Their de Broglie wavelengths are lambda 1 and lambda 2. According to question, they suffer perfectly inelastic collision and the final particle which is formed is having the de Broglie wavelength of lambda. We need to find the relation of lambda with lambda 1 and lambda 2 among the four options. So let's see what the right option would be. So, for perfectly inelastic collision, one most important thing is the momentum sum will always remain constant, right? That is, if the two particles are moving such that, when you see here, let me mark it for you, momentum P1 will be along this line, momentum P2 will be along this line. So, let's take this as P1 and this being P2, right? They are perpendicular to each other. Definitely, the net momentum will be the resultant of these two. And what would be the formula for them? So, according to the de Broglie's formula, you will be writing P1 is equals to H by lambda 1. And similarly, P2 would be H by lambda 2. And the net momentum we are expecting, P net, the particle will have wavelength lambda as per the question. So, vectorially, P1 plus P2 will be equal to P net, right? As no external force is acting on the system, net momentum will be conserved before and after the collision. So, starting from here, the vectorial sum, if I go by magnitude, I will write P net whole square would be equal to P1 whole square plus P2 whole square. Putting the values, I will get this relation. Right, on cancelling H, I'll get 1 upon lambda square would be equal to 1 upon lambda 1 square plus 1 upon lambda 2 square. I hope you have understood the answer. This is the final answer for us. Let's see which is the matching option to this question. So among the four given options, option number 4 would be the right answer to this question. Right, let's move ahead with our second question. Now, as per this question, it's a very easy question, belongs to a section of units and chapter of units and dimensions, section mechanics. Here, the dimension of under root of epsilon naught by mu naught is asked, and which of the four options are matching, we have to find. Let's start with the solution. Now, with this question of epsilon naught divided by mu naught, what I can do is, I can multiply it with epsilon naught up and down, both numerator and denominator, right? Doing this, what I will get is, this equation will be epsilon naught divided by under naught of mu naught epsilon naught. I think you are aware of this, that 1 upon under root of mu naught epsilon naught will be c, that is the speed of light. Now what I have to find is only the units or dimensions of epsilon naught. In order to find the dimensions of epsilon naught, it's pretty easy. From the formula of electrostatics, where you have 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 upon r square. The dimension of F would be M1, L1, T minus 2. 4 pi being a constant will be dimensionless. This is 1 upon epsilon naught. Q1, Q2 can be written as A2, T2, as charge will have the dimensions of AT, and this is AT into AT will become A2, T2, and this is L2. Solving this, I'll get epsilon naught as M minus 1, L minus 3, T 4, A2. Now, this epsilon naught can be put in this equation we have already found. So, putting the value here in this, I will get the real values of on simplification, I have got epsilon naught by mu naught, that was equals to C into epsilon naught. Now, the dimensions of C is equals to L1T minus 1 into the dimensions of epsilon naught is simply M minus 1 L minus 3 T 4 A 2. Solving this, we will get M minus 1 L minus 2 T 3 and A2. This would be the dimension of epsilon naught by mu naught. This is our final relation. I hope you have understood this one. Let's see which is the matching option to the same. So among the four, if you see, option number four would be the right answer to this question. Let's start with our next question, that is question number three. This question belongs to section of mechanics of chapter work, power and energy. As per the question, the particle moves in one dimension from rest under the influence of a force where that varies with distance traveled by the particle. That means force is not constant, it is a variable force, right? Now, the distance traveled by the particle is as shown in the figure, and we have to find the kinetic energy of the particle after it has traveled 3 meters. Now you are very well aware of this fact, that is area under the curve for force and position graph will give us the work done on the particle, and that work done will be equal to the gain of kinetic energy as per the work energy theorem. So what I have to do is, I simply have to calculate the area under this curve, right? Now it's very easy to find if you understand the basics of same. So for the solution, we have to find this as area 1, this rectangular portion, right? And we have a trapezium, which is area 2. And at the end, I have just to add both the areas, I'll get my answer. Let's start the solution of same. So for work done, that would be equal to delta into delta kinetic energy. That would be equal to sum of the two areas. Now, for area 1, it would be simply length into breadth as it is a rectangle. As you can see, length and breadth both are 2. It simply would be 2 into 2, that is 4. Right? Then, if you talk about A2, A2 being a trapezium, that is half into sum of parallel sides, which are the two parallel sides, this and this, that is 2 and 3, and into the breadth, that is 1. So that would be equal to 2 plus 3 into 1. This is simply 2.5. That means the work done or change of kinetic energy would be 4 plus 2.5. That would be 6.5 joules. I hope you have understood the question. Now let's see which is the best suited option here. Among the four, fourth option is the right answer to this question. I hope you have understood all the three well. Let's move on to our next question.